guys, welcome back to North Fork. I'm Maddie, and thanks for joining us today. Right now, we're just going to cut these trees up that we drug out of a path to clear it. Right now, it's pretty chilly. It's starting to get to fall. We started back at school, and hopefully you stick around to see our rest of the video and see what we do. Hopefully all this fits on the truck, and if not, we'll come back for more. Asher is here today, and Asher, you want to say hi?
Hi.
And Adam is building a fort, and it's nice out this morning, Saturday, to be just out and playing. It's a little chilly, but we don't really care. So there's already one row that isn't completely finished. We added some sideboards on so we can stack it higher on this old green truck, and hopefully all this fits.
So we've got two oak trees and a maple tree that we pulled out, like Addie mentioned. And
Daddy was fixing a chip roll over here.
So both the oak trees have been dead a couple years. The maple tree we just cut down, but we're going to cut it, and we'll probably split it for next year, maybe even the year after. We got a lot of wood right now, so. All right, so we got the first log cut up, the first stick, but we forgot to record it. Must not have hit the button or something. So we got it all loaded up in the back of the truck, that first piece. And we're going to start cutting some of these little ones here on this end and loading them up and keep going. So it's going pretty good. Even when you're throwing it into the truck like this, it's nice to throw nice and loose, so that way it makes a nicer pile and pull off a lot easier. Doesn't take a whole lot of extra time just to throw it up there neatly, you know? You can stack some up on top of that other. Job. Stack it up as high as you can up there.
Yeah.
All right, so while Addy's stacking in the truck, I'm going to use the Mingo marker and mark the rest of these and continue cutting. So we're probably about halfway done. And we're just going to keep trucking. Alright, so when I was just cutting that last stick there of maple, hit the ground and accidentally, so probably had to put some fuel in it anyway. It's getting pretty low, so I figured I'd touch the chain up at the same time. Take both the fuel and the oil. Usually I touch the chain up every tank, but I filled it this morning. I'd used it some the other day, cutting some trees down just in the yard here. And I hadn't sharpened it after that, so it was only half sharp anyway. The chainsaw?
Where?
On the ground.
Where?
With the chain.
Where were you cutting?
Down where that maple is.
Down where?
Down there where those pieces are cut up. So this is one of the 2-in-1 chainsaw sharpeners. Very similar to the steel. This is a preferred brand. I'd talked about it before on the channel. It's nice just to give a quick go over as you're out in the woods or in the middle of sawing. You know, if I really hit a rock hard or damage the chain, then I have an electric chainsaw sharpener in there on bench mount that I'll use. But for the majority of the time, 95% of the time, I'm just hitting it with this a couple times. And it's good enough. It files the rakers and the tooth at the same time. Does a really good job at it. So go ahead and get this finished up here. Get back to cutting.
Gonna keep on cutting.
Thank you. All right, so we got everything cut up and put in the truck. So we were using the Steel 261. So it's probably my favorite go-to saw. I like the 362 as well, but the 261 just, it's only got a 16-inch bar. And for most stuff I do, it works pretty well. So 362 is definitely a faster saw. Cuts a lot faster. But, you know, for the majority of what I do, I'm just enjoying being out here in the woods and cutting. You know, the 261 does a great job for me. Just nice and light in the hands, and it cuts well. So, anyway, I got the truck over half full, probably three quarters of the way full. So,
three rows.
Yeah, we got three rows pretty much. And so I thought it would fill the truck all the way up. If it was split, it probably would be. There'd probably be a full cord there if it was all split and stacked. But right now, it's probably only three quarters of the way full in the truck. So, that truck definitely holds a lot. You know, there was three or four trees there, lots of firewood. You know, that firewood there is all hardwood, maple, and oak. Majority of it's dried, dead oak. And, you know, that'll burn for probably a month and a half in the wintertime, give us heat. In the summertime, that's about 3 months worth of hot water right there. Probably only took us about an hour and a half to do that, Addie helping. And so, yeah, not too bad at all. You know, we drug the logs out there the other day with the loader. But all in all, everything seemed to go pretty well. So we'll get this thrown off onto the pile down there. We'll get it split up here this winter and stacked and ready to go for next winter, maybe even the winter 2021. So we got lots of firewood. We just keep working on it slow and steady, and we never run out. So you guys have anything to say?
Bye.
Bye.
All right, thanks for watching, and we'll catch you on the next one. The truck?
Yeah. Daddy.
Daddy, I have a seat in the car.
Now can I talk?
What are you going to talk about?
I'm filling your eyes out and all that stuff. Mom's up in the house, all that stuff.
Well, how about you do it after I'm done cutting?
Why, Daddy?
Because I'm in the middle of making a video.
Daddy?
Yeah?
Can I touch this now?
Yeah. No.
Oh. What are we going to do?
Sharpen the other side.
Where?
On the chain. You ask a lot of questions.
Yeah.
I know you do.
Daddy, okay. Do you like a big chain? I mean a big one?
Big chainsaw?
No. A big tree over there.
What kind of tree is it?
I don't know.
Is it a maple?
No.
What kind of tree is it?
It's a big one.
Well, that's not a kind, that's a size.
Size.
It's a big tree?
Yeah. Not too big. I mean.
Do you like that big tree over there?
What big tree?
The big one that you were talking about.
Huh?
You do?
You mean the maple one?
No, the big tree you were talking about.
Yeah.
Well, that's good.
It has big pieces of bark. What's this for?
It's a wedge.
What?
So when I'm cutting, if the tree starts coming together, I put this in there to stop it so it doesn't pinch on my bar and get my chainsaw stuck.
Or break your bar.
Oh, it's coming to you.
All right, last tooth.
What?
Last tooth.
Now,
we're going to finish cutting.
Can I down?
You went down?
Yeah.
You're going to have to because you don't have earmuffs.
But wait.
I need your mouse.
Guys, can I get down? Can you get